Hello, and welcome to the 17th year of Strings Unlimited. This is the first spring concert we've done in 2 years because of COVID. We canceled last year's spring program, but we did an outdoor concert in Clarinda in September, and we recorded a Christmas concert in December and put it on YouTube. So we have been a busy group in spite of the pandemic. Our first piece for you tonight is Night Rider, followed by a piece called Little Critters.
Thank you.
over the years, we've had a lot of family members join Strings Unlimited. The most we had was the Pena family. There were five of them at the same time in the group. We've had mother and two daughters, another mother, daughter, a son, mother, siblings. I myself have always had a mom and almost always a daughter in the group. And this year we are going to feature a mother-daughter duet. Jill and Lucy Gandy are going to perform for you. Amazing Grace is one of the most beloved hymns that we know, but its origins are not quite as innocent as you would expect. It was a poem written by John Newton. John was born in 1725. He's kind of a troublemaker. Well, actually always a troublemaker. For many years, he was a slave trader. His language was so bad, so rough, that it even offended the Navy officers, which, you know, pretty bad to offend the Navy. And eventually, though, met a woman, fell in love, changed his ways. Doesn't always happen like that, but that's what happened with him. And he wrote this poem. It was set to a lot of different tunes until it settled into a tune called New Britain, which is the tune we know it as today. And they estimate that it is performed around 10 million times every year. This is Amazing Grace.
Thank you.
viola, cello, bass. Those are the string instruments that I teach in our program, Strings Unlimited. This is the smallest violin that I have. And then the next smallest. But seriously, they do make smaller violins for students. So if you're interested, or cellos or bass, they do make the smaller sizes. If you're interested, we'd love to have you. You can contact me. My email, BeckyKia66@yahoo.com. We're gonna next perform for you Downton Abbey. This is a little rubber chicken cake pop. A lot of times when people are watching stuff on TV, like TV series, Netflix, PBS, whatever, they need a little munchies. So, you know, I'm gonna maybe eat some cake pop, watch Downton Abbey. In Strings Unlimited, we play music that was written for a professional orchestra and kind of watered down into an arrangement for students. Other times we play music that was written for students. And there's a group called ASCAP, A-S-C-A-P, the American Society of Composers, Authors and Publishers, excuse me. And they have some really great composers that write works for groups like ours. This next piece, Polka Dot Polka, is one of those pieces. If you know anything about the Beatles, you know that they went through a phase of writing some kind of psychedelic music, like I Am a Walrus or Lucy in the Sky with Diamonds. Well, in 1968, they came out with some a little bit more down-to-earth music. This next piece is Lady Madonna, commonly known to be written in like as a tribute to working women, mothers. And tonight we're going to feature one of our violinists, Elliot Smith. He also plays percussion. And I just want to take a moment to thank him, because every time I have, if I need something with the lighting or with the sound or just a little extra help with something that I don't know anything about, Elliot's my go-to guy. And he's also a really good percussion player. So we're happy to have him in the group and have him joining us on the drum set for Lady Madonna.
Thank you.
year I play a solo with this group, and lately I've been doing solos that use the orchestra as my accompanist. And that's a challenging job for them because they have to go without a leader. I mean, I'm playing my own thing, but I'm also playing something very loudly different than they are right into their midst. So they have to follow me, but play independent of me. So it's a good challenge for them. And I think that each year they step up to the challenge better and better. This year, I'm going to play the Meditation from the opera Thais. Thais is the main character. She is a woman of, we'll just say, ill repute. And there's a priest who notices her and wants to convert her. He thinks she's beautiful and falls in love with her, but his mission is to convert her. So in between the first and second scenes of Act Two, he has gone to her and made his pitch for her to leave her ways and convert. And this is the meditation that plays while she's thinking about it. Hey, I forgot to mention that we had a little incident with the camera in my solo. So when something like this happens, I'm really sorry.
Thank you.
Before we play our last piece, I'd like to thank Faith Community Church. They host our group each and every Monday night from about the middle of August until the middle of May. And we appreciate them very much. And I'd also like to thank Carol McCormick, Marlis Conrad, and Connie Johnson, because they help financially support our music. They donate music or they give me money to buy music, and I appreciate their help quite a bit. Our last piece is a bluegrass piece. This was first performed by Earl Scruggs on his 5-string banjo. This is Foggy Mountain Breakdown. It's been played for chase scenes in Bonnie and Clyde, and there's probably a lot of other music scenes. What are you doing? What's going on in there? Oh, he wants to dance. All right. Well, we're going to let the rubber chicken dance. You have to have cowboy boots. So I think because this is kind of, you know, it's a bluegrass, you got to have, oh, whoa, looky there. All right, then. You can dance. Woohoo! Here's Foggy Mountain Breakdown.